But if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, maybe you'll get sick of being the monster out of my head, under my bed. Think you're something out of my nightmares. See me right there. But if
what's up, everybody? Moose Motors here with some unfortunate news. We lost the 335 IS. So before we get in today's video, I do want to apologize for the lack of videos for over the last month before leading to the accident. I have been very inactive on YouTube. I got caught up with life, and then the accident happened, of course. I did have a lot of plans, a lot of video ideas that were in the works with the 335 IS, but unfortunately, can't get to that anymore, can't do those. And then the accident happened, of course. This is my 6th, 7th time recording this video over the last 2 weeks. I got into an accident on August 20th, 2 weeks ago. Exactly 2 weeks ago from today. And I just can't bring myself to make this video. It's very heartbreaking and unfortunate. But I feel like I'm ready. So I'm basically going to go over my side of the story, what I'm allowed to say for right now. Talk about plans for the future, of course, where this channel is going to be leading to. And I did record some clips of the accident the day after the accident. I went to the impound, videos of the car on the tow truck, and just never got to it. I couldn't record it. I couldn't edit. I'm not feeling it. I'm just like heartbroken inside out. Physically, I'm just happy to be alive. Besides all the pain I'm going through right now, I'm just happy to be alive to tell the story. Mentally, I'm drained, but I feel like I'm ready to get my side of the story out there as like a video. A lot of people have been asking for this video. I posted a video on TikTok of how the accident happened as well. I had like 500,000 views, and a lot of people wanted my side of the story, a video of me sitting down talking about what happened. So here we are. I do want to thank every single person that's contacted me, reached out to me, they're sending their condolences, checking up on me, hundreds if not thousands of you. I love every single one of you and I appreciate all the support I've been getting lately. So I'll leave all the clips at the end of the video. I want to skip to the part of the video where I show off the car, the damage, the tow truck, some clips of other videos I've never posted. I'll probably throw everything together at the end of the video. But getting into the video, I'm going to talk about the accident, how it happened, tell my side of the story and what the plans are for the future, where this channel is going to be going. So if you're familiar with the Michigan area, the car scene over here, you know that there is a cruise that happens here every year. Once a year on Woodward, it's called the Woodward Dream Cruise. And this year it took place on a Friday and a Saturday. It took place on the 18th and the 19th of August. I got into the accident on the 20th. And if you know Woodward, you know that every single weekend, it doesn't have to be the cruise itself once a year, but every single weekend, there's hundreds of cars, hundreds of people that meet up on Woodward every weekend. Just to have a good time with the boys. It's not necessarily racing, anything bad. It's just people parking their cars, showing off your car. And then there's hundreds of people driving back and forth, showing off their cars. Basically a place to have a great time with your boys. That's exactly what was supposed to go down on Sunday, the 20th. And the way this accident happened, I was out with my friends Robert, MoviQ, and their friend Zach. You guys know Robert and MoviQ from the previous videos I posted before. So if you're familiar with Southfield Freeway here in Michigan, you know it's very hectic. Everyone's driving like it's Fast and Furious. Speed limit is 55 on Southfield Freeway. The way this happened was we were going on a cruise there to Woodward. It was about a 25-minute drive for us. We all merged onto Southfield Freeway. We had MoviQ in the front. We had Zach behind him in the 370, and then Robert behind him in another 370, and then I was in the back of the pack, just following them. And we were all in the slow lane because our cars are very low. They're very like a few inches off the floor, and Southfield Freeway, it's not really the best road to be driving on, especially for people that are static. We don't want to mess up the undercarriage, hit too many bumps or whatever. So we took the slow lane basically all the way to the right. There's three lanes, so we took the right lane all the way to the right. That one had like the least amount of dips in the road or whatever, so we're just trying to save our cars from getting damaged. We were all doing a steady 55, 60 miles per hour, and there was supposedly a guy behind me driving very recklessly that I did not see because there was traffic behind me as well. It was very busy on Southfield that day. So this guy, I'm not going to say what car he was in, but he was in a very big SUV. He was cutting up traffic behind us, and I didn't see him. And he jumped from the fast lane two lanes over to the right lane where I was, and I'm guessing there was a car to the left of me that was blocking his view of me, so he couldn't see me. So when he cut two lanes over, his front right end of his car hit me very, very, very hard on the back left of my car, and that caused my car to slide and go up a 30-foot dirt hill, hit the guardrail on top, do a complete 360 and come back down to the freeway itself. It's a small accident to his car. It didn't look like that much, but it did hit his frame, so they deemed it totaled. My car is completely totaled. It's fixable. Anything's fixable, but it's just not worth the money, the time. It costs like $15,000, $20,000, $25,000 to get it fixed again, and it's never going to drive the same, so it's just not really worth it for me. I walked out of it alive, and that's all I can thank God for. I did lose my dream car. I lost something that I worked so hard for. Put so much money, time, I put my heart into this car just for it to be taken away in 10 seconds by somebody's reckless behavior. It wasn't worth it for him at the end of the day. I'm glad he stopped. He checked up on me. He was still in the wrong. The way this accident was, if I put like a picture on the screen just to show you guys the rear end of the car. When the fire department and the police pulled up to the car, or they pulled up to the scene on me, they came up to me and they asked me, like, was your car parked when he hit you? And I'm like, no, bro. I was going 55, 60 max. Their jaws dropped to the floor. They told me he had to at least be going 110 to 120 miles per hour to make my car look like that from the back while I'm already driving at 60 miles per hour. I had all my windows down, sunroof open. We were all just cruising. I was not expecting it, and I did not see him behind me because of how fast he was going. He wasn't even in my view. So if I was looking at the mirrors, which I was the whole time, he was not in my view until he cut two lanes over and he was right behind me. That's exactly when I saw him. So I couldn't avoid it in any way. I just gotta give a huge shout out to BC Racing for the amazing coilovers. I had the BR series coilovers, and that's what I'm thanking for my car not rolling over. I had adjusted to very stiffness all around, and the big ass wheels I had on the car, that I believe that's the only reason I didn't roll over. If I did roll over, I probably would have walked out of that alive, to be honest. My car stayed in like one position, but just like went sideways, up, 360. The back window shattered, everything that was inside my car and in the trunk flew, and there was like a 60 foot trail of everything that was in my car, all my belongings down Southfield for like 60 feet. It was horrible. It was a very bad accident. I'm still feeling all the pain in my body 2 weeks later. But I'm just happy to be alive to tell the story to you guys. Very unfortunate. Nothing really major going on for the car. I still do own the car. But I'm just not gonna... It's not worth fixing it. I still have almost all the parts right behind me. I still have my old set of wheels, all the turbos. I got the alternator throttle bodies in there, whatever, spare parts. Can't really do anything about it. I'm just planning on parting it out. And for the future, I'm not sure how long it's gonna take me to get another car. Maybe we'll get another E92, maybe move up to the M's, M3, M4, who knows. What's the craziest thing about this accident is that I don't remember my dreams. So when I sleep and wake up, I don't remember my dreams. Like, I'll remember it for that, like, 5-10 minutes I'm awake, but then I'll completely forget about it. That morning of the accident, before the accident happened, I had a dream that my car was stolen from me while it was parked in front of my house. I don't know why that's been stuck in my head, but that same exact day, like 6 hours after I woke up, I got into the accident, I lost that car. And like I said in the beginning of the video, I did post this on TikTok and it blew up, but it's getting a lot of attention. A lot of people are knowing me for the accident, my car, everyone's sending their condolences, which I appreciate. But a lot of people were confused or upset with me when I was saying I lost my dream car. So this car was a 2013, and I don't want people to be thinking like, oh, my whole life, like, oh, I want the 2013 335 IS. That's not the case when I say it's my dream car. I didn't even know what a 335 IS was until a week before I bought the car. When I say I lost my dream car, I'm saying that I lost the type of car I've always wanted growing up. I've always wanted the car that grabs so much attention. I wanted the car that inspired so many people, a car that motivated people, made people happy, made me happy, a car that I built myself. I could probably say that I built it, it wasn't bought. I put all the hard work, all the blood, the sweat, the tears into that car. That's the type of car I've always wanted growing up. And out of the three cars I've owned my whole life, this was the car that did it all for me. This car gave me a name. This car made me known around the community. This car made me so many friends. Like, I've met a lot of people through this car. That's the dream car to me, and I lost that in a matter of 10 seconds. That's pretty much it for the accident. That's just my side of the story. Again, alhamdulillah, we're alive. That's all I can say. And I do apologize again for the lack of videos. I wish I got two or more, got more content for everybody. Thank you to everybody who's been supporting. Thank you to the hundreds, thousands of people reaching out. If you guys would like to follow, subscribe, all my socials will be down in the bio, my Snapchat, TikTok, Instagram. I'm very active on those for right now. YouTube, it might be a couple of videos here and there, maybe some vlogs, me parting out the car, going out with the friends whenever I have the time to. But it's just hard to say without a car to make content on at the time. So again, thank you everybody for reaching out. I love y'all. But what I do want to say is that we are still going to be doing the giveaway for 500 subscribers. I still do plan on giving away $500 or an item worth $500. But I do want to add a small twist to it. I might also be taking a part off the car while I have it. So maybe like the front emblem, maybe a piece from interior, maybe the downpipes or the stock turbos, whatever the case is, we'll figure it out. But I want to give that away as well with the giveaway. So we're not too far from there. We'll still probably hit it. I'll announce everything about the giveaway on my TikTok, my Instagram. Snapchat as well. Thank you guys again for all the support. I will probably see you guys. I can't even say when the next video is. I have no clue. I don't know what the plans are. I'm in a very tough situation right now. Like, I don't know what the next step is. It's gonna take time. It's gonna take some healing. Hopefully, we'll be back on our feet soon to make even better content. Make an amazing comeback. I had to take a couple steps backwards to move forward. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will hopefully see you guys very, very soon. Enjoy all the clips I'm about to leave at the end of this video. We'll see what the future holds for us. Guys, so it's the next day after the accident. I'm here trying to get my car, but I can't get my car out today. They're trying to charge me almost $1,000 to get my car out of the impound and for the fee for them to tow it from the accident to here, plus the overnight fee. Almost $1,000. I don't have that in cash, and they only accept cash apparently. And it's an additional $300 to get it towed to where I want to get it towed to. So we're gonna say fuck it, come back tomorrow, get charged for another overnight charge, and get it towed to one of my boys' shops. Unfortunate events, but I can't even go. They won't let me videotape in there. They won't let me get pictures, videos, nothing. We're here with Paul Walker and Lil Wayne. They in the car.
Fuck Detroit.
Fuck Detroit, dog. What the fuck is going on, YouTube? Sad day in the industry.
In the car community.
Nah, I think I got a concussion, bro. We lost the
BMW.
We lost the BMW 335 IS.
Just type everything and let him read it.
I think I have a concussion. I think I'm retarded. I'm more stupid than I usually am. I'm having very, very bad stuttering, and I feel so much slower and stupid than I usually am. But we got in a horrible accident yesterday. We lost the car. That's basically it. Thanks for watching.
What are you doing, liar? It's right there.
No, it's not, man. It's my neighbor's car. Must be nice. I still have the keys to the car, but I don't have the car.
The car right there. Just try it.
Is that my car?
No, that's not your car. That's a fast car. You know it's fast.
Please. I want this one, please.
Shut on three.
What the fuck? Who the fuck ordered the house on Amazon, dog? Absolutely fucked.